Here we go.
And now, it's story time with your host, Carl Childers.
I read a good bit these days. I ain't never read nothing that scared me until last week. Mr. Bill Cox, he gave me a book that plumb gave me cold chills. It is called Alice in Wonderful Land. I can tell you about it if you want me to.
I'm in.
All right, then. Well, sir, once upon a time, there was this young gal named Alice. Lived over here in England somewheres. She was a pretty little thing. No bigger than a squirrel. She kindly bored one day. She wandered off summers. She seen this here white rabbit come running by. He's wearing a windbreaker and no drawers. Seemed like a lot of animals in them storybooks and cartoons wear hats and coats and whatnot. They can't seem to find their drawers. Donald Duck, Porky Pig, even that old Top Cat. Old SpongeBob only one ever got pants and they're might square. Well, sir, that old white rabbit, he kept looking at his watch and saying, I'm late, I'm late, I'm late, over and over again. Mr. Bill Cox said his name is probably John Boy. Alice chased after that white rabbit there, and pretty soon he dug down a hole. She went after him, and down she fell. Fell a pretty good spell there. Had a chance to read a book, do some color and whatnot. Then for some reason that hole ended in someone's parlor. Some folks calls it a living room, I calls it a parlor. The only way out was a tiny little bitty door. She was all put out on account of she was too dadgum big to get through it. Mr. Bill Cox says he sees a lot of women at the Walmart got that same problem. She see this little bottle sitting there, had drink me written on it. So she drank it. All of a sudden, she shrunk down to almost nothing. She was so small, in fact, she couldn't even reach a doorknob of that tiny little door there. Then she saw this cookie that said, eat me. So she commenced to gnawing on it. She started growing and growing so much she barely fit in that parlor. Mr. Bill Cox said whoever wrote this story must have found something that said, smoke me. I didn't understand that part of it. But she was so upset at all the topsy-turvy shenanigans going on that she started a-bawling. She's so big, her tears started to flood and washed her away. When she finally run up on dry land, Summers, Alice met all kinds of oddballs. A big old worm smoking a pipe. A talking egg called Humpy Dumpy. The Worcestershire cat. A big turtle with a cow head. And some talky walrus. Mr. Bill Cox said it looked like all the girls left over when the bar closed. Mr. Bill Cox could be kindly cruel time to time. Well, sir, little Alice, you finally got a chance to make a break for a spell. She met this Mad Hat feller. He invited her over to a tea party. Mr. Bill Cox said Alice is probably going to get audited now just for going. I don't think they have the IRS even in Wonderful Land. That's probably why they call it Wonderful Land. Alice heard a commotion and wandered into a game of croquet played by a deck of cards. Queen of Hearts there, she was the one running the show. She's mean-spirited. He's holding up these pink ostriches upside down and wallop these spiky little guinea pigs around. You figure royalty like that, they'd be able to afford the real thing. But when things didn't go her way, she'd fly off a handle and start hollering, cut the heads off, cut the heads off. Mr. Bill Cox said it was like playing wordy word with Mr. Hanson. Well, sir, before they could cut anybody's head off, some feller up and stole the Queen's Pop-Tarts. That place went plumb wild. Mr. Bill Cox said, Pop-Tarts is what he and his friends did in the Navy. And then he said, get it. I didn't. Well, sir, one of them playing cards went up on trial for stealing them Pop-Tarts. Little old Alice there, she was a witness. She started talking, and the Queen of Hearts didn't like what she was saying and started back to hollering, "Cut her head off, cut her head off." I ain't right sure if it was all the growing and shrinking or swimming in tears or tea partying. But little Alice, she had enough. She saw red. She picked up a guard's big old battle axe there and she got to business. She even went after them croquet playing cards. That white rabbit, he jumped up and yelled, "What'd you cut the cards for? What'd you cut the cards for?" Then she let him have it. All of a sudden she woke up. She figured it was just a dream. Then she found a bloody rabbit's foot in her pocket. Moral of the story, don't get in the middle of other folks' troubles, especially if you're a rabbit without the sense to put his drawers on. The end.
Storytime is brought to you by Hargrave's Potted Meat Product, now available in original flavor and new extra peccary. Hargrave's, chock full of peckers and lips since 1937.
You want to see my rabbit?